In 3 minutes, I'm going to summarise what will be 3 years of work and answer 3 questions. What is the antimicrobial crisis? What is causing it? And what is being done to tackle it? Antimicrobials, of which antibiotics fall under, fight harmful bacteria to keep us safe from illnesses. They've been used for over 2,000 years and we rely heavily on them in our modern day lives. But by 2050, it's predicted the world's leading cause of death will be by antimicrobial resistance, surpassing even today's of cancer. To explain what this crisis is, I want to first quickly talk about this game called Plants vs. Zombies. You don't need to know much about it to understand the point I'm making, but the concept is really simple. You are defending your house against an invasion of zombies by primarily using these green plants as cannons. Picture the zombies as the harmful bacteria and the green plants as the antibiotics. As the game progresses and gets harder, the zombies start to wear armor, which reduces the efficiency of the green plants as weapons. Similarly, bacteria evolving resistance mechanisms to our current medicine, leaving us vulnerable. This, in a nutshell, is the antimicrobial crisis. So the cause of this are probably things you're already aware of, like overuse and incorrect use of antibiotics. And you may think the easiest solution is to just create new antibiotics. The problem with that is we've already picked the low-hanging fruit, and to find new antibiotics, we have to stretch higher. This is taking considerable time and effort, meaning new strategies need to be explored. This is where I come in with my research looking at the bacterial resistance mechanisms. These bacteria can actually uptake antibiotics, but before the antibiotic can work, it's pushed out through these channels called efflux pumps. Certain efflux pumps aren't present all the time in the bacteria, but their production can be controlled by a genetic switch. This genetic switch is in turn controlled by something called a protein, which are like cogs in the cellular machinery. These proteins can also sense when the antibiotic is in the cell, and so you have this really elegant system set up in the bacteria. These proteins are specifically what I study, looking at the structure and function so it can be manipulated. This means we can design drugs to keep those efflux pumps turned off and lower bacterial resistance so that our current antibiotics can be effective again. To put this in the context of the game, I'm studying the armor of the zombies so we can develop new plants like the ones in blue to neutralize the armor so that our green plants can be effective again. This is just one area of research tackling the antimicrobial crisis. And there are many more. I hope my talk has brought awareness to a situation you may not have known much about before, but you're leaving feeling reassured there are solutions in the works. Thank you.